I'm Alan McGaughey. I'm a professor of mechanical engineering at Carnegie Mellon University. My group works in the area of nanoscale heat transfer. We're specifically interested in how the atomic structure of materials relates to their properties. We're specifically interested in a property called thermal conductivity, which describes how easy it is for heat to move through materials. There are two reasons why this research is important. The first is that when you make materials very small into nanostructures, like you might find in a computer chip, you can't look up their properties anymore in a textbook. And we need advanced experimental and modeling techniques to do that. The second is that we now have the ability to fabricate materials with an atomic level control, which opens up the possibility of tailoring their properties. So you may have the potential to, say, design a material that has very good heat transfer properties in one direction, but not so much in the other. My group works in computer simulations. We use tools called molecular dynamics simulations and lattice dynamics calculations to predict the properties of new and emerging materials. Because these materials are so small, we can gain insights from our simulations you can't get in an experiment. For example, what parts of a nanocomposite material offer the most resistance to heat transfer. This work is directly related to the generation and transport of heat and energy conversion devices. For example, solid-state lighting, like an LED, where you're converting electricity into light, or a solar cell, where you're converting light into electricity. We work in traditional materials like silicon and gallium nitride, but also in new materials, for example, hybrid organic, inorganic materials. Not a lot is known about the properties of these materials, and by making predictions of the thermal properties, we can inform scientists and engineers so they can figure out, are these materials sort of reasonable for actual devices, and they can also design thermal management strategies for their implementation. Many areas of mechanical engineering have been moving to these micro and nano scales, and our department has developed a series of courses to help students learn about the fundamentals. I teach a course in molecular simulation, where students use computer programs to model systems on an atom-by-atom level. Excess heat generation is a problem that's holding back the development of technologies ranging from electronics to energy conversion devices. And by studying materials and their behavior at the atomic scale, especially the thermal transport properties, we can hopefully make progress in this area.